So the Colorado Climate Center is tasked with providing climate information to anybody who needs it in the state of Colorado. So we do climate monitoring and communication of climate issues that are important to Coloradans. Drought is one of our most major natural hazards here in our state, and we work very closely, especially with Extension and farmers and ag, because we're at a public land grant university. So it is very important for us to keep our finger on the pulse of drought. NIDAS is an initiative that started in the mid-2000s. It stands for the National Integrated Drought Information System, and its primary concern is improving monitoring and getting drought information to the users who need it most. They came up with specific regions that they titled drought early warning systems, and one of the very first ones that they came up with was over the Upper Colorado River Basin. And the Colorado Climate Center came on very early on in 2009 and spearheaded the effort of drought monitoring in the Upper Colorado River Basin.
One late great climatologist named Kelly Redmond defined drought as insufficient water to meet needs. So if we look at who needs the water, 86% of the consumptive use of water in the state of Colorado is in the agricultural sector. So it's no coincidence or accident that the primary users of our data come from the agricultural sector. Pretty much anyone in the state who has a need for water is welcome to talk to us and may at some point use our data. COAGMET is the Colorado Agricultural Meteorological Network, so its primary focus is agriculture. We have 75 weather stations set up throughout the state, primarily in agricultural areas, so more in the low-lying river valley type areas. And the stations are equipped with everything they need to track evaporative demand. And so this is a tool that farmers across the state really like to use, is they can go onto our COAGMET website and put in the crop type that they're growing. It'll give them an estimate, which in most cases is pretty good, for how much water that crop is using. And certainly in the case of drought, the demand for water from the plants tends to go up.
Every Tuesday, we begin looking at all the data that we have compiled over the past week. We put it all on a website, and we have the precipitation, snowpack, stream flow, soil moisture. We look at every single one of those and what their percentile rankings are, and then we come to a conclusion about how the drought should be depicted over the Intermountain West region. Every expert that specializes in drought is doing this across the country for their own region, and then they provide their expertise to the U.S. Drought Monitor author, and then we want to make sure we get that expert recommendation to them for our region by early Wednesday so that they can incorporate that onto the map that gets released on Thursday morning.